Hello, here's Bentley, a little dog, he's a year old. Here's my greenhouse. In my previous video, I showed I had my plants indoors under light, and they grew their true leaves. So this is my outdoor greenhouse. This year, I put a layer of bubble wrap and then plastic over it, and then I did a clear coating over the door sides with the clear urethane coating. Used a sponge brush for it, and that's to give it my greenhouse tent more life, more years. And I've had the doors open today. It's been really nice. Went up in the 70s today. And it's getting evening time, so I just zipped it up and turned my heat lamps on. See, I got two red heat lamps, and then also have Christmas lights, and that just kind of generates some heat. And back there in the back, you see a set of steps. These were Maggie's steps, and she had a new porch built, and we brought home the steps to use in my greenhouse. And so I've got, let's see, sweet banana peppers, bullhorn peppers, Fresno peppers, different kinds of tomatoes, heirloom tomatoes, large sandwich tomatoes. I've got gourds, a few little cotton plants, some marigolds, and then I've got, rotunda, forgot what they're called. But anyway, they're a large sunflower type flower. It's not really a sunflower, big orange flower. But I did bulk planting in a lot of things, and I'll soon separate them out and put them in individual pots. I'll put several seeds in a pot. Let me unzip this. See, like here, I've got a bunch of them here. I'll separate them out and put them in bigger pots. I just got them started and going. But I usually check on the temperature. I get up in the mornings, I come out here, and I unzip it. Because it'll get hot if I keep the doors closed. See, see the zipper right there? That's a door. I have a door on each side. And here's the ceiling and the walls. And there's my temperature. It's been pretty much 80 degrees in here. It's gone down to 78. The sun is over in the west behind the trees. It's starting to set. So that's when I zip it up so I can keep the heat in. But I've had this tent now for, let's see, 1, 2, 3 years now, I think. This may be my fourth season. I don't know. But that's why I painted a clear coating on it so that it'll last. It won't tear and leak. But the big walls, you might kind of see the outline of the bubble wrap and the plastic on the outside. That's my loofah gourds, dipper gourds, birdhouse gourds, and then over here I think I have some drum gourds. Kind of leaning over a little bit. And now I did individually put in some of these tomatoes here. I separated out some the other day. I just do a little bit at a time. But anyway, that's what's going on. And I've got a couple of blueberries I've been babying for a couple of years. They're starting to look better. I thought I lost them. And I've kept them in the greenhouse all winter, just babying them because I thought they were dying. But they're rejuvenating. But anyway, I'll step back so that you can kind of see in and see the full thing here. And I know it looks kind of crazy with the lights, but I just thought that would generate heat. So I'm gonna zip it up down here in the zipper. Oh, my flooring, I saved chicken feed sacks. They're real thick, and I just put that down, and that keeps the floor dry and keep weeds from coming up. Zipping it up, and that's the sides. And back up a little bit. So there's my greenhouse. And in the mornings, it's bright sunny over here on this side, because this is the south side of the house. So, and while I'm at it, I'll show you my rain catcher barrels. Comes off from the house when it rains, and that's a rose bush that's growing up the side of the deck. And down here we got a spigot. You just turn it on. And I just put my water bucket under there and use that. And we'll go over here and water my plants or out in the garden. It's starting to green up out here. That's a rose bush right there, and it'll be blooming in a couple of months, or in a month. So, but anyway, that's my greenhouse.